Hello, first graders. Look at this cool book I found. It is called How Martha Saved Her Parents from Green Beans. It's an AR book. Here's the number up here, 160-182. It's the first month of third grade book, so your parents can help you out with that if you need. It has a really interesting cover. I just am curious about what's going to happen in this story, because here's a character with, an expression on her face. The dog here has the same expression on his face. If we look here, we have lots of, we know they're green beans because the words are our clue. And they have one with a pirate patch, one with a curly mustache, one with a downward mustache, and here's one with a full beard. And their expressions are not too friendly. So just interested in what's happening here. And if I'm wondering where this story takes place, what's the setting? I can look at this background here. There's a tall building, lots of tall buildings. And over here, sorry, there's even more tall buildings. So I would say that they are in a city. The city is a setting, and we have some curious looking characters. So let's go ahead and see what happens in How Martha Saved Her Parents from Green Beans. Doing this one-handed, so turning these pages is kind of hard sometimes. Doing my best. Let's try. All right. There it is. Every Tuesday evening, Martha's family had green beans for dinner. Every Tuesday night, Martha was left alone at the table, staring at a plate of green beans that she wouldn't eat. "Green beans are good for you," said her mother. "Green beans will make you big and strong," said Father. "They are both really wrong," thought Martha. "Green beans are bad, very bad." But even Martha did not know how bad green beans could be. Not until the day that a gang of mean green beans swaggered into town. These beans had black beady eyes and long curly mustaches. They wore tall cowboy hats and sharp pointy boots. They chased old ladies up and down the street. They threw rotten tomatoes at their teachers. They stormed into restaurants and tossed the cooks into garbage cans. Anyone who ever said, "Eat your green beans," would be in big, big trouble. Martha's parents were reading in the den when the beans barged into the house. The bad beans jumped on top of the furniture. They tied her parents with long leafy vines. They whooped and hollered and made lots of rude noises. Martha was in the kitchen staring at a plate of cold beans. When she heard the ruckus, she ran into the den. It was empty. The front door was open and a note was tacked to the wall. "We have taken your parents, the beans." No more parents mean no more nagging her to clean up the room. No more parents meant no more going to bed when she wasn't sleepy. No more parents meant no more green beans for dinner ever. "Hooray!" shouted Martha. She threw her plate of cold green beans right out the window. Then she grabbed a box of cookies and settled on the couch to watch her favorite movies long past her bedtime. Martha was happy. But not really. She missed her parents and wanted them back. By morning, she knew what she had to do. She marched out of the house and followed a trail of leaves that led her to a cave. Outside the cave, she saw her mother and father tied to a rock. They were surrounded by hundreds of green beans, laughing and dancing and singing off key. "Give me back my parents," shouted Martha. The beans did not even look at her. "Untie them right now," the beans only snickered. "Let my parents go or I will..." "Or you will what?" said the beans. "Or I will eat you," said Martha. The air grew cold and the singing and dancing stopped. The leader of the beans stepped forward and spat on the ground. "You will not eat us," he said with an evil sneer. "You have never eaten a green bean in your life." And he took a step closer to Martha. Then another and another. With every step, the bean seemed to grow larger. He climbed onto a rock and looked Martha in the eyes. "You're too much of a coward to eat a green bean." Martha's legs felt like melting butter. She wanted to run home and hide beneath her bed, but she pinched her nose, opened her mouth, and swallowed that big bean in one big gulp. The other beans gasped. Martha ate those beans too. When she untied her parents, they hugged and kissed her and told her how brave she was. Crunch, crunch, even the dogs eating the beans. From that day on, Martha's family never had green beans for dinner again. Instead, they had broccoli or corn on the cob or a nice leafy salad. Everyone knows that there is nothing bad about a leafy salad. What do you think? Hope you enjoyed the book. Don't forget, there's the AR number. 160182, and enjoy your gardens, growing your vegetables, and having them served on the table. See you later.